And welcome back to, this will be episode 3 of Destroyer of Worlds, the alien RPG. We are joined by our usual crew, and they are about to investigate an abandoned oil refinery, where they have been told they're going to they should expect some UPP, a couple of UPP agents, and maybe three agents, or sorry, insurgency folk there. So let's pick up where we were. You remember the oil refinery was way up in the upper right corner of your map, in the northwest, if there is a north. This is a moon, so north doesn't mean a whole lot, but there's this, you can see this whole abandoned section of the colony. It seems like people just up and left here maybe 100 years ago, and it's just fallen into disrepair. It has not been maintained in that period of time. And you can see off in the distance, actually it's not that distant, but off beyond the edge of the building area, you can see old abandoned drilling wells. So what is your approach here?
Remember last time we said something about it's a walled facility?
Yes. Yes, it is.
And I think we were trying to scout basically the possible ways we could get in.
Okay, so, and are you scouting by driving around, or is someone out and scouting? Okay.
And we've got some binoculars.
Binoculars won't help you too much here, because there's so many old, broken down buildings that get in the way of having a view. So you're close enough to see what you need to see, or you kind of have to get close to see what you want.
I don't want to send someone by themselves to scout. I think we're just going to unload the vehicle and lock it up. And
okay, do you want to point to me on the map where you want to stow the vehicle then? Like how far?
Well, I mean, is this like the outer wall on this side? It's hard for me to see exactly what I'm looking at.
Yeah, so this is just the point. The building itself would really just stretch about that far, right? It's a small part of this whole area.
We're parked maybe here. And okay. I do remember that last time Iona rolled fantastically on silence, like she was going for a quiet approach. So
you guys got in, and Iona found a nice concealed way in, almost just by instinct, and found this place. And you can see on, you know, you have a readout of the colony on your APC computer. So you can see, you know, that you are close here, and this seems like a good place to stop and get out.
And as player information, just a reminder that the insurgent that we spoke to said that they were hunkered down in an office.
Right.
Okay.
So as quietly as possible, you know, as the vehicle's being kind of put in, locked up and put in standby, captain's just standing outside the vehicle, kind of signaling for people to finish gearing up and come on out. Okay. And then I think we're going to head toward the wall.
All right. Are you all moving in a group? Are you spreading people out?
I'm going to partner people up kind of the way they're currently partnered.
Mm-hmm.
So me in front, and then two by two by two. Okay. Little bit of distance between us, but not a lot.
Yep. Yeah, it'd be standard procedure to keep some distance. You don't want to all be bunched up where a single explosive device
can right,
be
right.
Yeah. So, okay. So you approach the outer wall, and you can see that I'm going to show you the map of the of the whole refinery, but you only really see the eastern side of it. So you kind of know, and you can infer what's on the other side from the maps you've seen, but you can see, I think the first thing that really stands out to you is that the wall, the eastern wall, is largely collapsed. You see all these gaps along here where the wall has crumbled in irregular places. So like there used to be a gate in here and a gate in there that were steel gates, and those are still shut and a little rusting, but they're not doing much right now because there's these gaps in the wall with rubble. Like you would have to make your way up and through it, but and I'm assuming you guys aren't, you're not quite that close yet when you see this, but that's all the room on the map. So you're actually, you know, a couple dozen meters off to the east. There's a building not far away that you can see this from.
Okay, so this is the outer wall, or this is... Yeah, this
yeah,
was the outer
wall.
Okay.
This is the outer wall, and you can see there are these gaps where there's rubble and stuff.
Okay.
Collapsed.
Which ones... Silva's gonna try to look... What looks passable?
The easiest one looks to be this one, actually. You could probably get through any of them, but that's the one that has collapsed the most and would require the least amount of sort of scrambling to get through.
Okay. She'll signal to the others to follow, and she's going to hunch down to create a really low profile, especially if there's rubble that can kind of disguise their mm-hmm. passage they move along.
There's ample cover once you get up to the wall because, as I said, it's collapsed, so there's rubble that no one has bothered to clear away.
Unless directed otherwise by Captain Silva, Hammer will take up the rear guard position.
Fine, just stick with your partner. So this, you said this one or
mm-hmm.
the one up?
Yep. Okay. This is probably the easiest to get through.
So she'll just pull out the binoculars, kind of prop herself up against some of the low, you know, the rubble that's at chest height, and, you know, look into this area.
Okay. I'm going to let you make an observation roll.
Okay.
Now you're making my rolls.
Everything seems quiet. I mean, there's no obvious. I mean, it's not like you'd be blind. If there was an army camp there, you'd miss it because you failed your roll.
Who else had the other pair of binoculars? I know we had two.
The car? At the minimum? Let me check Smijewski.
Well, last time we had talked about picking them up, and I thought someone else had. Actually, I thought it was Hammer, but
it might have been, and I am forgetting as a player. I did not note them on my sheet. So if you ordered Hammer to get them, then Hammer has them, absolutely.
And she'll gesture to the binoculars and then to him, and like you know, scan the area.
So he will do as instructed.
So you can just roll one. So basically, when the two of you are both doing this, it would basically add one die to someone's roll. You don't both get to do the check.
Gotcha.
So Silva, why don't you roll one, roll it again, but with a minus three, and that'll just give us one die. And we'll see if that, if Hammer happened to see something you didn't.
When I give someone a command, don't they get a bonus on that too?
If you make your command check, yes. But in this case,
is that more of a combat thing?
No. But it's like right now, it's you're sort of he's backing you up, right?
You're doing the action.
If you had told, look at that success. All right, so Silva, you scan the whole yard here with your binoculars, and it looks very quiet and deserted, kind of as you would assume this place would be. There are a couple of rusted, broken down transport vehicles that don't look like they're probably usable out here. The place looks like it just, you know, probably one day the order came down to abandon the refinery and everybody just left everything where it was and left, and it's just sat there. Hammer, also scanning, does note, however, that it does look like some of the parts and vehicles have been stripped of things that would be useful. It isn't just completely abandoned. And he also he sees what appears to be in among the equipment way over here. He spots like a little all-terrain vehicle that looks in a little bit too good condition to have been something abandoned 100 years, or sorry, not 100 years, but abandoned a year ago.
So Hammer will use the hand signals that the Sin Eater Company uses to pass that information to Silva.
Okay.
She'll nod. And can we see like this building through this area here, or is there? Because it says there.
Yeah.
Pipe.
Yes. You see bits and pieces of it, right? Because yeah, the pipes are threading back and forth all through this area. So it's pretty it's a pretty complicated mess right in this center part. But yeah, you can vaguely make out a building on the other side there.
Right.
But there's nothing strange about it at this point. The other thing I should point out, though, as you look up here, you notice also that there are unexpected gaps in that wall as well. Other collapses. Okay. And actually, even down here, there are a few. So lots of ways in and out. And I mean, this is so collapsed, so badly collapsed that you could drive the APC through there if you wanted to. You'd have to, you know, you'd plow some rubble out of the way as you went, but you can easily imagine the APC just kind of making its way through with barely pausing to budge this stuff out of the way.
PC is probably usually pretty loud, though, considering its size, right?
It is, yeah. It's not really meant for... It's not a stealth vehicle.
Yeah. All right. Well, after, you know, taking another once-over, she puts the binoculars away, you know, gestures with her hand to move forward, and she's going to start heading out. She's going to basically try to hop from here to here and then make it down to here and use these for cover.
Okay.
And she signals for them to follow her lead.
Okay. Are Dante and Iona coming too?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're threading your way, you know, and there are little things not on here. There's as I said, there's pretty decent cover. There's a lot of abandoned equipment and stuff lying out here in the yard. So you could get decent cover if you needed it pretty quickly.
Question about these grenades: can they be remote triggered, or are they like
they
standard
cannot.
Grenades?
Nope. Okay. They're not. They could theoretically be jury-rigged to do that if you had time and the tools to do it, but they're not. They don't come that way.
Now you said the all-terrain vehicle was right there.
Yes, you can't see it now from where you are.
Right. Right. She's gonna kind of skim the side of the building and make her way down that way.
Okay.
Try to get a better look at it.
Okay.
She'll pull out the binoculars again, see if she sees any movement.
Yeah, it's hard to get a good angle. It's actually even harder to see the building with this angle now. Like all these pipes are now in the way. So
right, the office would be hard to see, but any yes. movement basically
yep.
in their
out,
path.
Out in here, exactly. Okay. Yeah, you don't see anyone.
Well, she'll take her time, be super cautious, and then signal for them to move out again.
Okay,
I'm assuming these are things we can pass under.
Yes, they
or
are.
Something.
Yep, you can pass under the. These you really can't. These go into the ground, but the cross the north south cross
mm-hmm.
pipes. Yes, you can definitely go under them.
When she gets to the vehicle, there she'll put a hand on it, see if it feels warm.
Okay, it does not. Which actually doesn't surprise you. It would only feel warm if it had just been turned off, you know, within the past 10
yeah.
minutes maybe.
She'll look over at Chaplin and signal to him, she'll point to the vehicle and she'll say I'm sorry, I'm like tongue-tied tonight.
Maybe
take it out of commission, make sure they can't use that their thing to escape.
Quiet hand signal that he understood, and he goes to work
to remove
two pieces that you'd need to use it, which he will keep. He's trying not to destroy it.
Okay.
Like a spark plug,
Yeah, easily done. You don't have to roll for that. That's just boom, boom, done.
He returns with the two pieces, shows them shortly, like for a short time to Silva, just to show, like, I removed these, and it puts them in his pockets.
She nods, gives him a thumbs up, and then moves on up to here. Again, stops to scout for movement.
Okay, I'm going to let you roll.
Alright.
I'm gonna give you you can add plus one bonus die because you've got all these other people looking around with you. So your impression of this back area here is that it's definitely disused like the front. But it seems just, there's just something about it that makes it seem a little more trafficked. You see signs that maybe rubble and refuse have been moved out of the way. Whereas everything in the first half, you know, that just looked like everything was just left to rust and where it was at the moment of abandonment. Back here, everything, it just has a slightly tidier look. And you do see the office building. It has a door here.
I'm sorry, I didn't see your ping.
Yeah, I can't see any of your pings. You keep saying here and there.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I may be on the GM level while I'm doing that. Okay. I've noticed it doesn't show up if I do that. So nice. You see a door here to the office. It's actually a fairly large door, so it looks like something that like a loader could be driven through if need be. And then you see a small window here, and it's broken and kind of iced over. And you think for just a moment you see movement in the window. There's just like a shadow back there that moves.
So this is like a big loader door that's gonna rattle and, you know, mm-hmm. go upward.
That's right.
Okay. All right. She's gonna point to this window and you know, signal that there's someone in there.
Chaplin and Smijewski already turned on their motion sensors on Chaplin's initiative, and Chaplin shows you the result of his scan.
Okay. I have to remind myself what the range is on that thing. I don't think it's very...
Probably plot. It has plot range.
Let me just see what it says.
Must be right in this room!
Yeah, I for the movies, it's really not that far. Long range outdoors. Okay. So, yeah, you think the it should be able to pick up motion as far away as the office, though it'll be a little less reliable at that range, of course. So you can go ahead and make your
because I have the 316 with a shorter range, higher reliability. Someone else of the players has a 314. That has a longer range, lower reliability.
So yes. Maybe yeah, yours is so the longer range one is the one I was assuming, because that
yeah.
the one you have that's smaller, that can just sort of be used much more easily with one hand. That's the one you have, and it really only goes to shorter range. It wouldn't really pick up stuff.
Then we need to find the player that has the M314 motion tracker, not the 16.
Let me see if that is Mason. I will check.
It's not either of my
remember,
people.
You can just click gear and it'll tell you what all your gear is too. You don't have to go to the sheet if you don't want to.
Oh, right. Yeah, Mason has an M314 motion tracker.
There you go.
Okay. Go ahead and make an observation.
For Mason?
Yes. Or, I'm sorry, Comtech, not observation.
Okay, Comtech for Mason.
Nice. Chaplin told Mason to be alert, so Mason's alert.
Yeah, and that so the stress like he he's or it's Mason, right? So she's a little jumpy. And she says, I'm picking up just the slightest bit of movement in there. There's someone in there, I think.
Now, when you say that window is broken and iced over, what does that mean exactly? Like, it's just cracked, or there's holes in it, or...
The window, yeah, the window's just cracked.
Okay.
And you, there is actually, I'd say about a quarter of it is actually just gone. Like it's shattered.
Who's got the, she's looking around, who's got the quietest weapons? Besides a knife, are any of the weapons stealth designed, silenced?
No, we don't have silenced weapons, no.
Okay.
We're expecting 8 people. 2 UPP, 3 of Stoll's people, local resistance, and 3 more Marines.
Yep. But the movement trackers ain't supporting that.
No.
Theory, yep, right?
Rocket launcher is silent once
well,
you're dead.
It only picks up people when they're moving. It's not like just, you know, somebody sitting there. It's not going to tell you someone's
thermal.
Sitting there. Right.
Right.
It's just picking up motion.
And did Mason actually have a little tremor in her voice when she said that?
Yes.
So Hammer gives her a look of just absolute scorn and derision. And just snorts.
She actually just completely ignores him. She doesn't even seem... You're not even... If she saw you, she's making a point of not noticing.
Alright, Silva's moving out then.
Okay, when you say moving out, like, is this a
headed
a
to skirt, here.
Like a quick
yeah.
Hunched run, kind of the
a quick,
combat
yeah, a
run.
A quick hunched run to here, a pause, looking around briefly again, and then...
Do the 316s work now?
Running to here.
And so just as a point of marine conduct kind of thing, like as the commander, you would, before doing something like that, you'd need to let the rest of the squad know what you want. Like if you'd make a hand signal for them to follow if that's your intention, or to stay if you're just going to go ahead.
She's signaling for them to follow, but keep it spaced, you know, normal spacing.
Yep. Okay.
So, basically, as soon as she takes off from here, probably the next group would...
Okay, so I need, let's see, Chaplain and, anybody that's moving up to the building right now in this kind of spurt of movement, I need them all to make stealth rolls.
What is that? Mobility?
That would be mobility, yep.
Just to the, like, outskirts of the building, not to this, like, little pylon,
yeah,
right?
To there, I'm fine. I'm more concerned with the people that are getting the closest to the building.
Okay, cool.
Good job, Zimushi.
No, it's okay.
Well, can I use one of mine?
In this case, all I really cared about was whoever had the lowest skill. I'm not going to, if everybody had to roll, someone's going to fail, right?
Oh, okay, I see.
So it's more, in this case, I'm just concerned with Silva, and she did quite well. What I like to do often is just, I'll pick someone at random and have them roll, and then maybe it's someone who's good at it, maybe it's someone who's bad, but in this case, okay, so you three got up to the wall pretty quietly, didn't stumble on anything or make any noise that you're aware of.
100% we would run the 316 motion sensor.
Okay.
Yeah. Paused here using the
power.
Motion.
Okay. Go ahead and give me a... you can give me your comtech roll. So one success. So I'm gonna say you definitely get just the slightest hint of movement on the other side of the wall. You're guessing around here.
Okay.
Near the center of the structure.
At least we're not surrounded, you know, and I find someone here or here.
No.
You know?
Oh, and the way this works, you know, you have to point it. So you're doing a 360.
Of course,
a sweep ball around. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Same with Smijewski, because then Chaplin and Smijewski could compare sort of with hand signals, go 3 that way, 1 that way, you know that.
Yep, yep.
But Smijewski probably just pulls up 0 and signals to Chaplin, and Chaplin shakes his head and goes 1 and points at the inside.
Okay, Silva nods. She's going to signal to this group to start moving forward to this side, and she's going to, you know, scurry underneath window level to this side.
Okay.
And signal to, you know, Chaplin and Jamuski to take position on this side.
Yep.
Okay. So you three get into this corner, being careful to pass under the window. And David, fortunately for you, the window is a little high up. It's not really at, like, waist level. It's more like neck level.
She signals for Zabuski to look around the corner.
Pop, pop. It's like friendly fire explained, it's the quick peek.
Yep.
Yeah.
Not to mention, we don't have motion outside, but you might as well just peek quickly.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. I mean, people are walking around. You'd pick that up if you're standing long enough. But yeah, someone sitting there or standing there, you're not going to pick that up. Yep. It's not that sensitive of, like, you know, if someone's just sitting there smoking a cigarette, it's not going to pick up the motion of a finger.
But it is, sorry my language, effing cold, right? Also?
Mm-hmm. It is.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. So that lowers the risk that people are just outside.
Yes. Oh, yeah. It's very unpleasant out here. But on the other hand, you know, these people that are colonists, at least, they've lived on this moon for years, some of them, and probably are a little.
They've got parkas made
it.
Of tragedy and regret.
Yeah, exactly. They certainly do. Okay, so Dante and Iona have made it to the southern corner. Hammer and Mason are covering from this tank here. Okay. Jamuski looks around. He doesn't see anyone. He just looks back and shakes his head.
Okay. Does Silva expect Chaplin to have pretty good observational skills, being a synth?
It all depends because synthetics are special designed for certain tasks. So some of them are very good at that sort of thing, and some of them are very good at physical tasks generally.
Well, she's gonna.
You would guess he's probably more the cerebral, because he's a med tech and electronics kind of guy. So he probably is.
She's gonna unholster her. Her rifle and kind of point it toward the window and back up a little to make room for Chaplin to go forward, and she's gonna, you know, put two fingers toward her eyes and point to him in the window.
Mm-hmm.
Acknowledges and sort of does a quick peek. His eyes are pretty good because they're grown. Or manufactured. Who knows? Wayland Yutani. Building better worlds. Boink.
And those eyes.
Oh man!
Oh yeah.
MK2 eyes.
So you're looking through the window. Is that what I heard right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So let's see. So you look through the window, and because of that, you got double successes. You see a face looking out the window, and you can either use your extra success as one of those things, or you can use it as a bonus to your mobility check to try to spot and then quickly jump back down before you are seen.
Oh, so either I can ask for more information, or I can make sure that it was just a quick peek.
Not make sure, just get a bonus on your attempt to... You're going to have to make a mobility
avoid detection.
Check because you basically looked right through the window at a guy who's looking out the window.
Wow, ouch. I think not being seen is the most important part, so the moment Chaplin's synapses register that there is a person, he would start moving back his head.
Okay. Go ahead and make a mobility roll then with a one bonus die.
ability. That's the modifier 1.
Yep.
Plus, is that correct?
One. Mm-hmm.
Easy peasy.
Okay. So yes, you see this face of a guy. He kind of looks like a homeless sort of fellow with a mangy fur-lined hat with flaps that go down over his ears.
One of Stoll's people.
And you quickly duck back, fairly certain, right? In fact, I'd say with 2 successes, you're quite certain. He happened to not quite be looking right at that moment you looked.
Yeah, it's also dark outside. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I was just in one of the corners, maybe behind the glass, trying to. Can I use the extra for a stunt?
Yeah, what do you want?
Whoever does sort of maybe another observation, like trying to assess the danger of the situation, maybe it helps them because I found already one of the people.
Okay, that makes sense.
You know, he'll quickly look over to Silva and make the hand gesture of one danger close and points right at the window.
Yeah, she sits there for a minute making a face and can tell she's thinking about whether she wants to. She's kind of hefting the rifle, like considering whether she just wants to take him out, but then she kind of shakes her head as if just to herself and then signals to Hammer and Mason to take this side, and she basically, you know, there's some signal for find ingress.
All right, Hammer sees the command and immediately moves the two of them to here.
And then she starts signaling to these people to move around this way.
And technically, just to insult you further, Hammer, technically it would be Mason moving you to there.
Oh, you're right, you're right. No, you're right, absolutely. I made that mistake, but I don't think Hammer would have. So Hammer would look to Mason and wait.
Oh yeah, and I'm letting you control her, right? So yeah, she does. She wants you to go first, though, right? I mean, that's...
Oh, for sure, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, and, so, Silva would realize that Hammer normally hates rear guard, so it is not his choice to be doing rear guard. So, Silva can file that information away.
Yeah, she's not... Oh, okay, got it. The signal was to find ingress, so you guys know that she wants you to find a door.
Yep.
Whether Hammer's smart enough to realize she does not mean the big loud door.
Yes.
Oh wait, there's a door!
And rattles it.
Yeah,
yeah.
And
yells it. Doesn't seem to want to open, Captain.
Just as Silva tries to sort of move away, the chaplain would sort of like hold her with the hand and sort of ask her with hand signals what the rules of engagement are. Or maybe feasibly we talked about that beforehand because we're Marines.
I mean, as a player, don't we all have communicators in our helmets?
You do.
I'm like 30 centimeters away from someone else.
Right. I'm worried that it like pops on with like a burst of static or something. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no,
oh,
hell
yeah,
no.
Definitely.
But I'm just wondering, either it has been established beforehand that Silva says, if we meet them, just mow them down. That's, you know, or like, it's chap... If combat
yes,
work,
you know. Right. It would have been standard practice that Captain, before you went in, you would have established rules.
What
of
are the
engagement.
Standing orders
are
in
you,
case of engagement?
Yeah. If they spot someone, do they fire?
Oh, she wants to take at least she wants to take the Marines alive if possible. You know, if not, but she'd kill anybody who gets in the way as far as UPP or these rebels, or but keep a leader. Like, they're gonna want to be able to anybody who looks like they're important. We're gonna try to take alive.
And this is shoot on sight. You're going in shooting, or is this a return fire? Fired upon.
No, this is probably a shoot first.
Okay.
As long as it's following the, you know, the like, if they meet one of the Marines, maybe try to shoot him in the leg, disable them.
Yeah, I mean, try you to could say, you know, we're live fire, you're fire free, but we're trying to take these Marines alive.
And she also wants one of, like, if they find some guy in charge here, she wants him alive too. But any mooks are fair game.
Okay.
And are probably just going to get in the way. And they're
right.
UPP, so bad guys. In her mind. All right, she would have signaled before she went for Dante and Iona. Is it Iona or
Iona?
Iona, to follow this way, so you didn't have to go by the window.
Okay, cool.
Are we free to move about the cabin?
So, is this another window right here? Just looking for an office door.
That actually is the door. That's an office door, like a normal door.
All right, she's just going to walk across here, and as soon as Hammer pops his head out, she's going to signal for him to come forward.
Is this a window or a door?
That is also a door. There are a handful of windows along the wall here, but you notice they've all been boarded up. That one seemed to be the only window that is not boarded up.
Does this door look functional?
It does.
Alright.
Under the impression that Dante's kind of the breakdown the door specialist, was that correct?
Anyone on assault teams, either Hammer or Dante.
Yeah.
All right, she's going to tell these two to try to bust in this way, and we're going to have Hammer and Mason, you know, be the... She's going to stand here at the corner and time it, basically, by, you know, giving them the now symbol for just try to bust the door down and break in.
If we're preparing an assault, is this something where mechanically we could roll again on the motion sensing just before?
If you want to do that again, you can. While she's lining up the assault.
Chaplin would do a sweep to sort of prep people.
So you're right next to Mason, who has the better motion tracker. So do you want to roll and add +1 for Mason's assistance?
They are different motion trackers. Mason's is more brute strength, long range, less reliable. Chaplin's is very short range, much higher sort of accuracy. So they, in combination, they probably cancel each other's problems.
So do you outrank Mason?
Absolutely.
All right, so you want to rank the roll then and just add +1 for Mason?
Sure.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Cool.
Yep, that worked.
Okay, so yes, you are picking up, again, faint readings. It's not a lot of motion, but you're getting...
It could be early or late.
Filtering out. Yeah, you're getting a couple of readings in the middle here.
Okay, he makes those signs, 2 readings inside, and then he says, sort of with the hand signs, 5 meters, 7 meters. He makes sure that Hammer knows that. For sure, because Hammer is, you know, tip of the spear.
Mm-hmm.
Hammer hand signals to Silva, where's Jamuski?
She furrows her brows.
Chaplin points and makes a sign for window. Like, he points back and says,
he's
covering window.
Okay.
She nods. That's acceptable.
All right. So so Silva gave Hammer the sign to go in.
Yeah. I mean, she'll eventually, you know, make sure that the right eyes are on her, and then she'll give them the now.
Chaplin
signal.
Will coordinate with Smijewski to make sure that Smijewski enters 1 second after Hammer enters. So Smijewski will just essentially put a gun probably through the window.
Yeah. There's some holes in it already.
Exactly.
Are we going in loud?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, there's I have no hope that we can do this quietly, so.
Just making sure.
Doors are probably locked, so. See if you...
Hammer will reach out to turn the doorknob to see if it opens.
Okay.
Hammer's got a smart gun, right?
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah, that's gonna be it.
You have to pull it up.
Yeah, so reaching out to check the door, if you've got to quickly, that's gonna slow you down a little bit.
Okay, right? So
you're firing with a two-handed weapon. That's a big, bulky, you know.
Mason, though, right?
Yeah.
Maybe Mason opened it for you?
If Silva's intuiting this, she'll signal for Mason to try the door.
Yeah, you know, I can't kick the door open with this smart gun, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, and Iona, too.
Yeah, I mean, you could, but it seems like maybe you're going to try to open the door, and if it's unlocked, if you open it with one hand, it's a little bit slower to get ready. Like you,
no, that's fine.
Your typical is to stand there, you know, both hands weapons ready.
Both hands weapon ready, and Mason opens the door.
Okay, Mason tries the door handle, and looks to you and shakes her head.
Okay. Well, we're going loud then.
All right. She looks down at Iona and kind of makes a doorknob twisty motion.
Iona
just,
will...
Just in case.
Yeah, Iona will check the door.
It seems like the door handle turns.
He looks back towards the captain and, like, thumbs up.
Okay, well, then she's going to give him the enter signal, and then she's going to give Hammer the go signal.
Okay.
All right, so Silva, you can make a command check.
Wait.
Push it.
You sure can, but make sure you do push first so that you get out of stress. Or just give yourself a stress.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Panic roll, but...
Panic roll, yes,
can't
first.
Be that bad.
You're just, you're a should, little, should a be little fine. On edge. Yeah.
Yeah.
Four.
Yeah, yep. you're okay. So you have... You're just a little nervous. Two successes, so you can give those two successes to one, or split them up between the two to get bonus dice.
Yeah, I'll split them.
Okay. So what's happening? Mason is gonna try to smash the door in quick.
Again, I've never been a Marine as a player, so what would be the standard operating procedure? Do we grenade the door open? Do I shoot the door open?
Oh no, with these kind of doors, I mean they're nothing. They look like they're the kind of door you could just smash in, kick it in.
Yeah, so then in that case, like I've seen it on police videos or whatever, you let the one person kick it in and the other person goes in with a gun.
Yes, yep. So
Mason, that's what we're going to do.
Mason will kick the door in. So go ahead and do this. I'm treating this as a close combat check.
Okay.
This is rough.
Unarmed, I presume?
That door had it coming.
Yeah, unarmed is fine. Or actually, you can just do close combat, the skill. It's not really a weapon.
Oh, I see. Okay, there's a button there. No modifiers?
Depends. You can use the one from Silva if that's what you want to use the bonus for.
I will use the one from Silva.
Okay.
Unless Silva says otherwise.
Go ahead. That's kind of what I thought.
Plus, so add one modifier.
Whew!
All right. So Mason kicks the door. It's a little heavier than she anticipated, but it does burst open. With one success, So that's quick. And on the other side, what's happening?
I think Iona, like, at the signal, kind of turns the knob, pushes it open, and then Dante moves in.
Okay, so Iona turns the knob and pushes, and about an inch in, the door hits something solid.
Crap, he's gonna try to force it.
Okay. Make a close combat roll, but with a -3.
-3.
Oh, but you can use your bonus if you want.
Yes, so you can make it a -2. Yes, it's clear something heavy has been put in front of this door on purpose.
Okay, I'll use my bonus on that.
Okay, so you have to make a panic roll before we resolve this, but otherwise it looks like you're going to get it open. Ooh, a nervous twitch. So we can click that 7 to see what a nervous twitch does.
Oof.
So, you and Dante both get 1 stress level. Like, so I can imagine, like, you go to open the door, and there's, like, this moment of, like, oh, shit. Like, there's something unexpected there, and you just sort of slam into it really hard, and it takes you a couple of slams to force the kind of wedge the door open, and you're just thinking shit, you know, the whole time. And Dante is, of course, not happy about this, too, so I'm giving Dante a... Or did you already give Dante?
Yeah, I added it to both of them.
Okay. All right. But you...
Majewski makes his move then also.
So Majewski didn't see the signal, so he'd be responding from you passing it on. So he's going to be...
Correct. Chaplin is the relay.
He's going to be just a beat behind. But
as planned.
Yeah. So Hammer... The door has... Mason has kicked the door open and gotten out of the way. Not as smoothly as maybe you would have liked.
Weak. All right. In I go. Ready to light it up.
Okay. You're the first in, because Dante and Iona are momentarily stymied over there. And yeah, you come in and you can see the whole interior of this office. There used to be probably interior walls here, thin interior walls, but they've all been bashed down, and it's basically just one big open area. With a few desks and old pieces of equipment and things lying around. So there is cover scattered around. But it's not a series of rooms, right? It's just one giant area. And in the middle, so your first impression is that in the middle of all this, there's a cluster of people. Less than 6 people is your first impression.
Okay.
So, I'm going to need you to roll initiative, and I'm going to also do some initiative.
Your pulse gun starts marking them. Beep, 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 beep.
Didn't that add that to... Okay. Yeah, it's just being... Is it being really slow, or is it not working?
Do you want me to roll for Mason as well?
Okay.
Are we all rolling?
It's really being laggy. You can. There's no harm in rolling now.
Okay.
All I want is for the teams. I don't roll for both of your people, because your team is going to act at the same time.
Sorry.
So I'm going to go with the player's role, not the NPC's role. So I'm going to pull Mason and Dante.
Perfect.
Okay. And it is actually, in this game, it is lower goes first. Okay, so you burst through, you see these people. I'm going to show you at least a couple of them. These apparently homeless guys, as you're coming in, they're reacting fairly quickly. And you catch in the dim light, and there's like a trash barrel in the middle of the room, with fire. Obviously, they were gathered around it for heat. That's your first impression. But they snatch up what appear to be long arms of some kind and jump for cover.
What cover?
There's just it's light cover. So okay. It's basically gonna count like all the stuff in here, just for simplicity, I'm gonna say counts as four armor. So it's not the best cover, but it's something.
Is it like old chairs and tables?
Yes,
and
old, yes, right.
Shelves?
It's old office equipment and shelving and things like that. Yeah, it might get lucky. It's more concealment than bullet stopping really. Just makes it a little harder to hit somebody is really the overall effect. Okay, so that happens. Chaplain, you're passing on to Jamuski, and so he can now react. What is he doing?
He will acquire targets through the window and start shooting at them.
Okay.
As per instructions were given, right? It's free fire.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so for this first round, when you're still like acquiring targets, I'm going to give everybody A-2 on their shots, just because it's, you know, you're sort of going in blind. So go ahead and yeah, you can take a shot at somebody.
Does he only acquire two targets? Is it only two?
I don't want to really have to make everybody roll, so I'm gonna say there's a couple people, and there is the guy right in the window here.
That's the guy he's nailing. Because that's okay. What he was prepared. And remember how Chaplin gave the next person trying this a plus one?
Yes, yes. Okay.
So that's storytelling-wise, he would have prepped Zemuski, and Zemuski would probably just take instead of going through the window with his gun, take one step sort of back.
Yep.
And nail the guy looking out the window.
Okay.
Or being next to the window and just go...
And because this guy is not really... Well, he's turned and he is moving, so that is going to make the shot a little harder.
But at least we're shooting him in the back.
You are. Oh yeah, he doesn't see it coming.
Yeah.
So where did I put that?
So it's still at a minus one, right? Or one? Yeah, it's one to minus one because you gave me a minus two. I gave him back a plus one.
Plus one.
So at a minus one.
Yes.
Okay, it's the pulse rifle, I assume.
Yeah.
Pulse rifle, and then I literally type minus one. It'll take
mm-hmm.
that.
Yep, it'll take cool. that, and it'll just everything. Every adjustment is more or fewer dice.
Oh man, did you hook up sounds to this?
I did.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's one success, which means no special, but that does hit. It is armor piercing. He doesn't have any cover, so and he has I believe no armor at all.
He got shot right in the
yeah,
back with a.
He's got no armor, so he does get he does take a hit right in the back, and kind
Center
of pitches forward.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Is there yeah? That's it, right? That's what people do. You move, shoot, your turn is done.
Yeah, you basically get a fast action and a long action, a slow action. So his fast action would have been to move into position to shoot, and then his slow action would be to shoot.
Yeah, to be clear, from the inside, you could sort of see the top of his shoulder and his head.
Yep.
Because of the, you know, the high window.
Mm-hmm. Okay, hammer?
Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna move to here.
Okay, that would be your fast action. So you're moving there, and there's, you know, there's simple cover for you there.
And, you know, the intention being, I know where my other people are coming from, so mm-hmm. I'm going to, you know, create up. And then I'm going to cut loose. I see that there are rules for full auto.
There are indeed. I should have reminded myself about them, but they're actually pretty simple, as I recall. You basically can... I think you have to take a take one stress to be able to go full auto. So yeah, what you do is
I'm going to stop you with full stress. I'm not going to do it.
Okay.
I don't want to stress at this point yet.
Okay. Yeah, let me tell you what it does though, so everybody knows what full auto does if it has capability.
Okay, thank you.
You get +2 to your roll, so you'll get more dice. Your stress level will increase by 1 before you roll. And then you can distribute any successes beyond the first success to targets that are reasonably close by to, it's kind of my judgment, nice. That are close to the primary target. And the advantage of spreading it out is that each of those bullets does the base damage for the weapon, which, like for the pulse rifle, is 2. So if you get 3 successes against 3, each one of those is taking 2 damage.
Okay, in that case, I am going to full auto. So take a stress, so yep. Hit the push roll button.
Yep.
Hoorah!
And then click this, and I put a -2 in, yeah?
Nope, just put a +2 in. Because you're going full auto.
Oh, he was talking, I think, about the -2.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So it's going to even out. So it's going to be 0.
Okay.
So just straight up.
Hi. A hit?
One hit on your primary. Who's your primary?
This one here.
Okay. He does have... he does have some cover, right? They all moved into cover. That one does block 1 damage, so he takes 2 damage. It rips through the desk that he's hiding behind, and you hear his cry of pain.
Do you all want me to also move Mason at this time?
Yes, what's Mason doing?
So Mason is going to move to here. Is she able to see a target when she enters the room?
She is, but she won't be able to get to cover with just a quick move.
She's going to spend her action getting to cover.
Okay. Yep, so she gets down into cover. Okay. Iona finally is smashing through that door. But like I said, it has slowed her down, so she has to use her fast action to finish getting through the door this turn.
Okay. Iona's a guy, by the way.
Yeah, I know. I'm thinking of you. Of you.
Okay. Yeah.
Go ahead. What All do you right. want to do? So you force your way through the door. You are now in the room, but you're not in cover.
Yeah. If Iona could try to get into cover, I think that's what he's gonna do.
Okay. Yeah, you certainly can do that, and you can move a little ways if you wanna
do that. Just there.
Yeah, then you can see there's another guy down here that's also gone down into cover.
Yeah, I think Dante is gonna be the one coming in, guns blazing.
Okay.
So she's gonna come in here. And does she see this person down here?
Yes, yep.
Yeah, I think she's firing at him.
Okay, is she firing full auto or just normal?
What? Sorry. Probably
yeah, if you guys normal. Got grenades, we can use those too.
Um, Okay, so she's got like grenade launchers and RPGs and shit.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying.
I doubt she would go bursting through a door with an RPG as the standard.
Yeah. The pulse rifle is just kind of like a regular rifle that she can use, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the standard issue.
I think she's gonna fire a good full auto.
You know. Okay. Is this full auto or standard?
Why not full auto? Let's do it.
All right. Give yourself a stress.
Before the roll, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Then.
So it'll be straight up. Straight roll.
All right. Straight roll.
Oh, nice.
That is two successes. So you can either use the second success as a stunt, or mm-hmm. you can hit another one of those guys that are, you know, one of these two that are reasonably close to that first one.
Let's hit another person then.
Which one? Closer one?
Let's do that one. Yeah, the closest
okay.
one.
So you hit both of them. I'm going to see if their cover does any good for them. First one, it does not. The second guy, it does sort of dull the bullet a little. You know, it slows the bullet down just enough. So they both got hit.
Okay.
So yeah, you guys have come in guns blazing. It's chaos in there right now. Silva
is going to, I'm sorry, my token's being wonky. Come in at a crouch. I think her first thing would also be to just assess and find cover.
Okay.
So, I guess she'd probably be about here. And
what is that's, he, what weapon does she have in hand?
Well, I had said before at the pulse rifle. Now, just as a matter of assessment, if you were using your grenade launcher, what's the range? Like, what's the area of effect range on a grenade?
So the primary effect would be, you see how I'm pinging?
Uh-huh.
That actually is pretty accurate about, you know, so...
So it's pretty dangerous to use.
It would be very dangerous to use in here with all of you guys in among them this close, at this close a range. Yeah, I mean, it might be okay, and there's an epicenter, and then it does reduced damage the next mm-hmm. range out. But you will probably end up hurting your own people.
Yeah, that sounds like a Hail Mary sort of a move, and that's not where they are right now, so...
Yep.
So she makes that little assessment as she kind of ducks behind a desk, and then just props her rifle up on the desk and to steady her next shot.
Okay. Okay, it's their go, and I'm going to make them all do panic rolls for this. Okay, nobody got a six. They're all a little unnerved. They will have minus twos to their attack this round because they were also... This is sort of them scrambling to try to do stuff. Okay, I get that, for Chaplin. All right, so this guy at the window, I think he's, hammer, call even or odd?
Even.
He shoots at you.
Sweet.
So he takes a shot with his pulse rifle in your direction with a minus two. And totally misses. Doesn't even come close. this guy here, I can see him going for any of the three that came in, so I'm just going to go die six from Mason onto Hammer. So, Hammer, you're the target again.
I did unleash full auto on him.
Yes,
so.
and you were the first in, so it's the most likely target.
Oh man,
that's why you can't hit. Awesome, baby.
Yeah. Though I would say with this guy, you can tell from the first guy, he seems a little panicked. This guy you can tell is more disciplined about his shooting. This guy back here, he actually, he doesn't have great sight on anybody. I'm going to just do it completely randomly, and he'll actually have a minus three. He's just Hail Marying a shot. This is going to happen to go in Mason's direction.
Oh, no.
Oh.
She's got a little cover.
He does. Let's see. Okay, so I'm going to say Mason is pinned down and has to make a panic roll. So
okay.
She takes Yeah, so go ahead and make a panic roll for her. That's what he would try to do.
Nice.
Okay, so she doesn't go for that, and she takes two damage, so she can make an armor check to see if that, and add four to the armor check.
Because of the cover?
Because you got the cover, yep.
Gotcha.
Alright, so that stopped one, so you only take one damage. That's the red, that's the red bubble.
One in the red bubble.
So you get clipped a little bit. But nothing too serious. This guy, I'd say Dante, is right in his face. He's going to shoot at Dante. He missed.
That's right, assault team!
And this guy could go for Dante or Iona. So Iona, call even or odd.
Let's go odd.
Yep, it goes at you. You're in cover. So that they all kind of unleashed a crazed, panicked almost quick return fire, but most of it the bullets went wide, didn't really do much. Okay, so Chaplain, we're back at you.
I will use my one action to keep using the motion tracker for the outside so that we don't get ambushed during our ambush.
Okay.
And the other action to stay in a cover, like crouch down, pulse rifle out, overwatch.
Okay.
It's called.
So go ahead and do a comm tech.
Okay. Hey, click. Yep. One success.
One success. So that's how sure you are. So there's definitely nobody nearby, but that's one success is how sure you are that there's nobody out there. So you if they're moving very slowly and stealthily,
right?
You might not pick them up, but yeah.
At that point, my eyes might pick them up also.
Yes. Oh yeah, I'm sure you're doing a up and down look. Okay, and Zhimouski? Or Zhimajewski?
He has eyes on, I assume, three people, right? That, and that?
Yeah, I mean, yes. Yep.
From his combat experience, was it obvious to him, as you had said, that maybe these two are moving in a much more combat-like fashion than...
I'm going to let you decide that, but I think his primary attention was on this guy he just blasted. But
yeah, maybe he'll just nail him again then, I guess.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, this guy, to Zhimajewski, doesn't even have cover.
Oh, yeah, then he just nailed him again in the back.
So it's just a straight shot.
Is there aiming or anything in the system? Anything
I think, and I don't... I thought I had that combat...
You can aim as a fast action, and there is a combat handout.
There is a ranged weapon. Yes, it is. Yeah. It's Z combat actions at the bottom there. Why is it? Yes. So the fast action, right, aim. And it doesn't tell you what it does, but I'm pretty sure aim gives you plus two dice.
Let's do it.
But let me check that. Yes, you get plus two to your attack roll.
And he could shoot full auto, right, if he wanted to?
He could.
Oh, but of course, these three, I'm not sure if they are within a good enough angle.
I'd say no, given the weird window.
That's all right. I'll just do a two.
It's kind of high. Like he's lifting his rifle up almost to head, you know, head level, and shooting.
Yeah, he shoots.
He barely clips the guy, puts another round into the guy's arm, and you see him kind of twist and fall to the floor. You're not sure if he's down or just.
Yeah, unless I poke my gun through the window, the angle is probably shit now.
Yeah, yeah.
That's okay.
Hammer.
All right, the hammer is going to continue to drift this direction along the wall. And full auto on these guys. So I'm going to click the panic button. Or no, the push roll button.
Just push roll. All
right, and then fire the gun.
With a plus two. And who's your primary target?
Primary target is the closest one to me.
Okay.
And then if I get a secondary target, there'll be the one to the east, and tertiary target will be the one to the west.
Okay. Two successes. So you hit this guy, and hit the other guy. So let's see if their cover does any good for them. Ooh, the first guy does get benefit of cover. You see a couple bullets from your spray go into the. He must have found like a partially metal, like an old sideways fridge to hide behind or something. Like it's been knocked down. The other guy here, yeah, a little bit. But yes, you've sliced through to those guys, and you see them instinctively duck down.
Was that this guy and this guy?
This guy and that.
Correct.
You said east, yep.
Mm-hmm. Yep, those two. Correct.
All right, and your compadre, your NPC,
Mason is gonna use her fast action to aim. And then she is going to fire at this one here.
Okay.
Hoping to catch them in a crossfire.
Standard?
Standard, yeah.
Okay. Plus two then.
And the plus two is for the aiming, yeah?
Yep.
Okay.
And the range is all like short range, so it's just no modifier. And just so you also know, with ranged weapons in this game, point blank is actually bad. You don't want to be right up in close combat range with someone to shoot them unless they're unaware of your presence, because it actually makes it harder to hit them, because any movement on their part really can throw off your aim.
True to life.
Yeah. So Mason gets two. That's great. So she gets one... stunt. What does she want to do with that?
She is going to cause... So her target was this lead guy here.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to cause him to drop his weapon.
Okay. He gets caught in that crossfire. And let's see if his armor helps from here. A little bit. So, yeah, but you can see he, in this hail of bullets, he had come up to take that shot, right? And you guys hit him, and he turns and spins, and the rifle falls out of his hands like a couple of feet behind him. You hear it clatter to the floor.
Perfect.
Iona and Dante.
All right, so... Iona, I think, is going to take shots at this guy at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Just like normal shots.
Okay. So you get a plus. Are you aiming, or are you, if you're not going to use your fast, there is one reason to hold off on your fast action. It allows you to defend yourself in close combat if needed. In this game, you don't technically have to do that. You can borrow your fast action from the next turn. But if you don't use it, takes an action to defend yourself from a close combat. So if someone rushes you, you might want to have that fast action. But if you don't think anybody's going to rush you, you might use it for aiming.
Okay, so. I'll aim then.
Okay, so plus two. Oh yes, armor piercing. You're right. It's supposed to. I should have done half of that. So really, only counted the first ones. So yeah, I'm not gonna. That's a good point. You actually takes five. Okay. Oh my goodness, three successes. And what do you want to do with those?
For
Iona.
My stunt. I think I would like him to drop his weapon, and I'd like to do another point of damage.
Okay, I'm only going to count the first two, because you guys, these are all armor-piercing shots. You're right, I should only be counting the first half of the dice. So, four damage, and he drops his weapon. Okay. Yeah, I would say, given that, I mean, his weapon flies out of his hands. He spins and goes down in it. And there's blood, like, you are quite sure you finished this guy. There's no question in your mind whether this guy is dead or not.
Yeah. Hypothetically, for Dante's turn, like, in this space, how big of an area would a grenade affect?
That was what Slip asked, and it's...
It's kind of a desperate move, it'll hit your allies.
The blast radius is enough that you won't be in the worst of it, but you're likely to get friendly fire out of that.
Okay.
If you threw it in the back corner here, probably not, but it also isn't gonna... Anything that's safe for them, or anything that's safe for you is probably also... kind of safe for them. This is not a great situation for grenades.
You're just too close. Got it. In that case, I think Dante's just gonna shoot at this guy. Just regular.
Okay.
And we'll do the fast action to aim.
Okay. So plus two. Ooh, alright. And what do you want to use your stunt on? That definitely hits.
Extra damage, please.
All right. And for this guy, yep. Didn't really help him. Okay. He has also, he's taken a hit and instinctively kind of goes down. He might be gone, you're not sure. Again, these are
okay.
It's a little hard to tell.
Got it.
And finally, Silva.
You want to make a manipulation roll? I'm gonna call out to these guys. Drop your weapon. Hold on, just a second.
Drop your weapons and start your press.
Drop your. Drop your weapons, men, and hold your both hands in the air, and you ain't gonna get fired on.
Okay. You can make a manipulation check. Let's see if that gets any...
Figured they're taking pretty heavy...
Yeah, they're under heavy fire.
Yeah.
Okay, two successes, and you get a stunt out of that.
So if I say they do what you want, it is. Am I basically picking individuals?
Yeah. I mean, so essentially, in this situation where you're trying to talk them into surrender, essentially, I kind of will determine if you just want to throw all those successes towards just trying to get as many of them to surrender as possible. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make them have to make panic checks based on how damaged they are as well. That's going to influence the roll here. So I'm going to go through. Okay. Okay. And what do you want to do for a fast action?
She'll use command, because she can use command as a fast action.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll say, folks, fire. Try to take out your targets. Don't, you know, don't spread it out. Focus fire.
Okay, go ahead and do it.
So if
what?
I guess that if this succeeds, if any two people start attacking the same person, they get that bonus dice.
Yeah. Yep. That makes sense. All right. So this guy here is... He's the one that dropped his gun. At this point, he starts to go for his gun, but the rest of them, this guy stands up with his gun above his head. This guy doesn't move, but he was kind of gonna aim at Hammer, but you see he just kind of puts one hand up. Hammer, he's still got his hand kind of his other hand on his gun, but he takes the other hand off the gun because he's like lying on the ground. He got like shot down to the ground. This guy over here, Dante and Iona, you see him kind of you hear his gun hit the floor and hear him going, yelling out not to shoot. And this guy was going for his gun, and he snatches it up as his fast action and takes a shot at Hammer. So no bonus.
The trained soldier.
Yeah.
Dang.
So that is only one hit, so you get to do your armor Hammer with +4 for your cover.
Okay.
Do it. You can do it. Oh man, yeah.
Oh yeah. No problem. It strikes the you feel it hit your vest, but It doesn't go through. So you feel the impact. I mean, it might even feel good. Hammer might like that, you know. Mm-hmm. and
pull my hair, Daddy.
And he yells something in you recognize it as sort of it's a vaguely Asian dialect that the UPP tend to use, almost like Russian, a mix of Russian and Chinese. And he It's something you've heard before. They like to shout. You were told it roughly translates into something like a die capitalist oppressor.
Nice.
Of course, you don't die. Chaplain.
I repeat my previous actions. I will scan for enemies and remain in a protective position.
Okay.
Overwatch.
All right. And Jimajewski?
Majewski will now, as he can't see the other person anymore, he will point his gun at the person that is loudly yelling and firing.
Mm-hmm.
And try to follow Captain Silva's yell to focus fire.
Okay. He is also out of cover. I mean, he had to get out of cover to grab his gun that he dropped. So he's like, I mean, you get the immediate sense the guy is just sort of like, it's his crazy last stand. You can see he's bloodied, like he's been shot. So
he'll aim at the shoulder and then hold down the trigger for a burst that hopefully makes the bullets crawl all the way up to the head.
Okay. So this.
My gosh.
Oh, gosh!
Oh my gosh!
Oh yeah, he explodes.
Oh my god!
In a hail of blood everywhere.
That's crazy.
And as he goes down, you know, he's still got his finger on his pulse rifle, and it just it's going off at the people around him. I'm gonna make a random roll to see if he accidentally hits anybody or, you know, whatever. No, okay. Fortunately, nobody else gets hit, but it scares everybody. You know, like everybody kind of just ducks down all these guys. But they all
head explodes.
They all come up, except for this guy who was on the floor. He just kind of.
He's
almost forgotten that he even has his gun in his hand, in his other hand, and he lets go of it.
Could I use, if there's any leftover for the character, it's important for Zmizewski that he's able to impress his squad, because he wants to, you know, go up the ranks.
Okay. Yeah, he can do that.
One of the
stunts
for
sure.
That.
I can see that. I mean, it's a very impressive, it's a very impressive pattern.
Clean up.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And there's, I assume nobody keeps shooting, or you can if you want. That's, I mean, I'm not going to do turns, but.
Silva will hold up, you know, her fist, like, you know, cease fire.
Mm-hmm.
And yell out, cease fire as well. And then she'll, you know, say, Chaplain, Jimewski, get your asses in here.
Do you actually prefer yes, ma'am, or yes, captain, or yes, sir?
Probably sir is everybody's called.
Chaplain yells, yes, sir! And then...
So Hammer just makes sure that all three of these people who are still in motion, are still alive, know that he has them in Smart Gun, you know. So they don't.
You said that one of them besides this guy had seemed more like a trained soldier. Is that person still up too? That guy?
Yeah, I mean, he's the these two guys, you know, he kind of backs away a little bit. He's put his gun down. I don't know that you remember which one of them seemed more.
Okay. Well, she'll say Dante Hammer, zip tie him, put him against that wall over there.
Okay.
So as Hammer and Dante are doing that, Hammer's like, do you see that shit? Right there in the chest, baby! Yeah!
As Dante is zip-tying, says, Captain, This one here in the middle has a UPP vest on under his coat.
Well, that's stupid. And she comes forward and says, bring that one over here. Separate them.
She does.
Okay. So, when's them Marines supposed to get here? I mean, you can make this easy on yourself or you can make it hard.
Don't but speak it's... English.
Oh, you don't? Well, I think we have some universal languages over here. And she, you know, takes her butt of her pulse rifle and just shoves it in his gut.
He says, you get nothing from me but my name, rank, and serial number.
Oh, that's all right. And she pulls out her pistol and holds it to his head and she says, this guy ain't got nothing for me. Anybody got something for me? You know, they say loose lips sink ships, but here, loose lips get to leave the planet alive.
They look at each other a little uncertainly. I'm going to let you make a manipulation check here, but with a minus two. This guy shakes his head, but the guy that Jimajewski put down twice, he looks like he's in real bad shape. Like he's almost dead. He's having trouble even standing. And he says, you gotta get me some medical help. I'm not gonna make it.
Zemujewski, bring him over here. Chaplain, see to this fella.
You will notice that Chaplain was about to give medical aid to Mason.
Oh.
And he gives you a questioning look. Looks at Mason, looks at the guy.
She doesn't want this guy to bleed out before he can talk. So she kind of looks over at Mason and says, you all right, Mason, for a minute?
Sure.
Mason's like, yeah.
Which one is the guy? Is it this one?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Zemujewski goes to cover him, and then Chaplain walks over and uses his talent to heal someone who's about to die. It's called Field Surgeon.
Okay.
Gets a plus two when he does medical aid on someone about to die.
And I just gave you a command, so I'm going to roll that too. you have to make a panic roll.
It's fine, you're the captain. Nothing's going to happen.
Four. With a command, I'm
Six,
actually huh? gonna say it doesn't help because there's just a bit of nervousness. Like it's, you're either distracted or a little bit nervous. So Chaplain, just go ahead. I mean, it actually helps when you look at him, it doesn't look like he's not as bad off as, you know, like I'm about to die any minute now, but.
But also, no plus two?
It looks worse than it is.
Okay.
Yeah, just a normal.
Okay.
Roll. I mean, and really, the medical. It's okay. I mean, it technically. I'm
good
kind
chaplain
of,
roll.
I'm fudging a little bit here anyway. You don't really heal people with that. You really more just stabilize them. But you can tell like he's gonna be okay anyway.
Will make him maybe more talkative.
Yeah. I mean, you go through the like you do what you got to do, right? He should be bandaged up. He's been shot. But you can see that the bullets went through. They were not.
Yeah.
They were not really. They weren't life-threatening shots in and of themselves. So. You know he's going to be okay, but there's a lot of blood, and it looks bad.
Okay. I'll tell him, you better tell the captain what they want to know. There's a lot of blood here. Not sure I can save you.
got it, man. I got a kid.
Silva pulls out a cigarette, you know, like just really casually, and lights it and starts smoking while he's jabbering on.
He looks down. You can see he looks really worried. He says, am I gonna make it, Doc?
Silva kind of looks over him at Chaplin, because she probably doesn't know actually how bad he is.
Yeah, Chaplin. To Silva, I would say he looks like he could be bleeding out. Chaplin knows he's not, but yeah. To everyone
Chaplin,
else,
Chaplin
looks
to him and says, "Don't talk to me, talk to her."
He turns to the captain. And he says, "Please, man, I got a kid. I gotta get her off the planet. Please." She's got nobody.
Should have thought about that before he threw in with the UPP.
I'm not in with the UPP. I work. And he stops himself.
Oh, now. And we were starting to get along so swell. We do have limited medical supplies here. Maybe I don't want Chaplin to be wasting them on you.
Understood, Captain.
Look.
One less colonist.
Look, I'm just a guy trying to make a living, okay? Botus just, he feeds us.
Who?
He takes care of us.
What? You kind of went out when you said that.
Botus.
And she kind of jerks a thumb at that guy. She says, him?
No, I don't really know him. He's our, he met us here.
Where's this Botus?
He's at our HQ.
Oh, I see.
He's supposed to. They're gonna bring some prisoners to exchange for something. I don't know. I'm just supposed to be here waiting. We're just supposed to keep the place secure.
How close are we to their meeting time?
He didn't say exactly when. He just said we needed to wait here until they brought him.
I see. What else did he say?
I don't know. I mean, they're important to the UPP. That's all I know. He doesn't tell us more than we need to know in case we get caught.
You know, these Marines, were they coming in willing, or were they talking about them like they was prisoners?
He didn't say.
Yeah, well, what was your impression?
I wasn't part of the discussion. I just take my orders and do them.
All right, Chaplin, I think he's earned himself a Snoopy Band-Aid.
Yes, sir. He bandages him up.
Okay. So that's gonna take. Actually, is gonna take a little while. I mean, he took two shots, and it's gonna take a little bit to.
Do the stim packs do anything, or are they also for stabilizing?
No. What the stim packs actually do is they just help you power through the pain.
Also, they reduce sort of negative modifiers you might have.
Well, what they do is they remove one of your hits effectively, but you gain. It's like you're trading a stress level for a hit. So you're gonna increase your stress, but it essentially lets you ignore one damage point.
Does it make you loopy at all? Is it like
if you do enough of them, yes. That's why you're adding stress to it.
Oh, let's have a party. I have 15.
So if you sit there and you pump yourself with three of these, you are making yourself loopy and a little jittery.
Well, that might. Yeah. I'm thinking of it in terms of loosening someone's lips, when someone's on.
Like morphine or something.
Morphine or something, yeah.
If you pumped it with enough of that, yes, it could.
Certainly. I do have a med kit if we needed to misappropriate some morphine. But, you know, I also have a surgical kit.
If you would have just removed a kidney.
Yep.
Never know when you're going to need one of
those. The guy's looking back and forth between the two of you and said, I don't need my kidneys removed. I told you what I know.
Well, you did leave out one little tidbit. What? Where's the HQ?
Oh, shit. If I tell you and Botus finds out, I'm a dead man.
She, kind of gestures to Zemuski to kind of block vision, you know, get Chaplin and Zemuski to kind of block the view from over here.
Okay.
And she kind of hunkers down to where he is on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And she says really loud, "Well, ain't you a stubborn one? Ain't gonna talk, are ya?" And she kind of makes a, like, just kind of thunks the floor with her foot or something to it. Makes a sound like maybe she kicked him or something. Mm-hmm. And then she's going to say, "Now, where's the HQ?"
He says, "I'm not telling you anything."
And then she says, "I get it. You ain't going to tell me nothing, are you?" And then she's going to make just like a slapping sound with her hands. All she's
I'm going to let you make a manipulation roll for this. That
she's giving him an out. She's trying to.
Yep. Okay. Two successes. I think
A and B, if I can get them.
Yeah, I think, well, it would just be one or the other. I think the A means he's going to be willing to tell you, like, in detail, and not bargain for for any. He just says, it's on the other side of the oil fields, the northwest district of the colony. He says there's an old building. It's it used to be a transportation hub for transport vehicles. It's got a stone wall around it. Botus is usually there in the house there. That's what we've been using for headquarters. You know, he moves around pretty frequently, but that's where he was earlier today when he told me to come out here.
How many men are there?
Oh, jeez, maybe 20.
Let's see. But, how many are UPP?
Says, you know, he sends them out on the, you know, jobs to do and stuff, so maybe not all of them there at once. Says, I don't even think the UPP knows where it is.
So Botus is kind of a go-between then, making some money from the UPP.
He says, "Nah, he leads the insurgency. He's the leader of the movement here."
Yeah, but what's the? What's his interest in selling intel to the UPP?
Well, they're helping us. They give us supplies and info. That's what he says.
He's a turncoat, is what you're telling me.
He said he had enough. He said he saw how corrupt it was. And that it was just helping rich people get richer. And they were just being used. He says, "You Marines just get used." He said he had enough of it. And he was going to fight for the people for a change.
People like me. Yeah, and I bet he don't take a cut, does he?
Well, everybody gets a cut.
And his ain't any bigger than anybody else's?
Not that I know of. He's one of the most upstanding guys I know. Real decent fella.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure. Where's your daughter at?
Your impression, he seems to believe that. Whether it's true or not, he certainly seems
Silva doesn't believe in it. I mean, she's pretty sure that any turncoat Marine is probably a asshole.
Hey Doc, stop, that hurts, man. Look, I can't tell you where it is. I can't. I told you everything I know anyway.
She says, well, if you ain't gonna tell us anything, you go in that, take him to the corner and make sure he stays quiet.
That was to Chaplin or was Mizuski?
Probably Zamuski.
He just sits there looking at his bandages and worrying, and he like sticks his finger underneath one of them, and he just seems like he seems really worried, and he says to Jimmy Juski, you know, he says, I'm not gonna bleed out, am I? He did a good job, did he? Is he a good doc?
Stares him down and says, we'll see. Shut up. Chaplin is happy to talk to Silva and sort of advise her that we could make this our own trap.
Yeah, she's gesturing to Hammer and Dante and Iona and Mason to circle up.
Hammer snaps too.
The other people.
You can see that Hammer was having a little fun with this prisoner over here, but as soon as Silva motions to him, it's all business.
Yeah, Iona's been searching kind of the bottom part of this room. Just to make sure nothing was missed, but once he kind of hears his name, he'll move over this way.
Alright, well then Dante is gonna herd the guy over here and keep an eye on both of them then. She's not gonna leave them unattended.
So Silva's gonna say, well, Vela says that they got an HQ, an old building up in the used to be a transpo hub. Probably guarded by about 20 men, but their leader's some washed up turncoat Marine named Botus is leading them. Might be useful. We might have to go talk to that fella. But until then, you know, as long as we weren't overheard, you might be able to get the jump on whoever brings the Marines here or the Marines themselves if they are coming of their own volition. I think we need to position ourselves so we are prepared. Stay here for, I don't know, a good 6 hours. And if they don't show, then we'll move on to Plan B.
Yes, sir.
We're going to need motion detectors, people with the motion detector stationed outside, or someone can just be at the window there to keep an eye on that direction. Maybe someone at this at the door here. And otherwise,
do we as Marines have sort of tactical deployment understanding?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Of what we should be doing. Because yeah, I'd rather not. What if we hunker in here and they decide, these are probably not the people we want to meet, and then they throw grenades in the room and we're all dead, like stuff like that, or I don't know how we like set up an ambush. As a player, I have no idea. But our characters would, I assume.
Well, yes and no. I mean, there's a lot of improvisation that goes on. It's reading the situation. Yeah, I think that is a good basic tactical principle. Don't bunch everybody up. right? You want somebody who's like a, you want to establish a perimeter of some kind, not just everybody bunched up in this room. That was, in your opinion, that probably was a very unprofessional move to have five guys just sitting around a barrel with one guy at a window. They obviously weren't expecting trouble. They weren't giving any vibe that they really expected anything to go wrong. So, you would want to have a lookout somewhere that could have oversight, and keep an eye out. You know, you want a security post somewhere.
Chaplain would advise these things essentially. Maybe no, put people on the distillation towers or...
If their HQ is in the northwest, and assuming that this is northwest, they're probably going to come from that direction. Probably.
And then we'd probably have to discuss at what point do we bring the trap.
I can show you the map.
You know, once they open the door, once they go inside, once we can just, you know, once we see them all, we just start shooting. You know, who knows?
He said they were across the oil fields.
Across the oil fields. So just a little north?
For clarity, as a player, he means the Ariarchus insurgency are across the oil field?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and not the UPP.
No, they're dealing with the UPP because the UPP is funding them.
Yeah, so the oil fields are all scattered out through here. So
he said northwest.
He's talking about somewhere over here.
Oh, okay, so southwest. Okay.
I mean, you're in the absolute ass crack end of the colony up here. There's nothing up above you.
So they'd actually be coming from over here, probably, then.
That's certainly the direction he was indicating was across the oil fields and in that northwest section of the colony.
Yeah. Maybe we should hide. Maybe Chaplin would say we could always hide the APC better, now that we know that we have a sort of an ingress vector for them.
Yeah, that sounds like a smart idea.
Captain, you want me to take out the trash?
She shakes her head. That one, she points to the UPP person. He's valuable. Reckon we can drop him off with the guards who are up at the spaceport when this is over and done with. That one, she says, I'm not sure how useful, if this is the other guy who just wasn't talking.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't certain what I want to do with him yet. He may decide to be useful. Maybe he's just going to be a little bit of human shield in here.
Well, we don't want him giving away our position, though, so maybe you get him a little night-night?
Well, or a good gag. Gagging them does sound like a good idea, actually, so...
Alright, so Hammer will go out over and take care of that as gently as he does everything.
Okay.
Hey, Captain,
this guy here is seeming a little woozy to you, and there's actually a lot of blood when you kind of haul him up. He's been sitting in a puddle of blood for a while. And you can see his whole right arm is just kind of covered in blood that's been rolling down. He hasn't said a word.
Is that the one that Captain Silva said might be useful? Or is that the one that Captain Silva said she wasn't sure about?
That's the one she's not sure about.
Well, if he bleeds out, then it's a tragedy, isn't it? So, Hammer doesn't say anything. Just ties him up, gags him, sticks him in a corner.
Yep.
Was Iona saying?
He basically asked if he wanted him to get the APC and bring it closer.
Yeah. Make sure it's, not visible from the northwest part of the oil field. Park it somewhere closer by, but, you know, out of view.
Silva says, I'll go with him.
He just kind of nods. And he'll head out.
Okay, so Iona and Silva head off to...
Not Silva. I'm Silva.
Oh, I'm sorry. Iona and Dante. Yeah, sorry.
Dante.
Iona
yeah.
and Dante head off to get the APC.
Okay. And then we'll have to, you know, put, I guess, Chaplain and Mason. Maybe position themselves out as surveillance, especially with the movement detectors or binoculars.
Well, I'd recommend, or Chaplain would recommend.
Yeah, the scanners really aren't that great for surveillance and spot, like,
because it's so short.
It's such short range, and it's very directional, right? And
is there anywhere to get
like
high
you,
up?
Like you have to. You have to, you know, scan slowly to really get a good read on anything. It's really more for when you're expecting trouble. Or
we do if someone was on this tower and just kept scanning in that direction.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Is there a high up place that we can get? Yeah, like the distillation tower.
Sure. Yeah, there are ladders on the sides of those that you can climb up. I'm just saying that once you're up there. Those trackers really, I mean, your naked eye is going to be far better than a tracker when you're up
yeah.
there. We're talking about these ranges in this, you know, site. And
What about rifle range from the top of the distillation tower to the bottom? Is that going to be bad?
No.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be fine?
Yeah, I mean, it'll probably be medium range to most things if they get into the compound here. Long range if it's, you know, way down at the other end, or, you know, approaching that. That's like long range.
All right.
What if we decided, because the APC has actually a turret on top and they might not have such a thing.
Mm-hmm.
What if we decided to use it in the ambush?
Yeah.
As sort of a trump card. Either we bring it in from the north, from that way.
If we parked it right here, they probably wouldn't see it. From either way, because you said that we can't see past these, really.
Or we have it come in from behind them at some point, right?
What happens is it's very hard to see this way through the pipes. This way, it's not so hard. So if you were to park it here...
You could see it from here.
And they were coming from the other side, they could see it. They may not recognize what it is, but yes, it's...
It would be a gamble on what direction, but I think that might still be good. Maybe park it over here.
It's certainly better than wide out, out wide in the open.
Mm-hmm. We could try to maybe camouflage it a little with metal, corrugated metal and stuff like that. If there's other stuff around here.
Oh yeah, definitely. There's lots of debris and things that you could, you know, pile up against it that really wouldn't impede it if you needed to drive it away. You just plow it right over. Yeah.
Does it fit inside one of these cargo containers?
Like those waste hopper things?
Yeah.
It's a hopper.
Yeah.
It's like a waste. It's like the back of a dump truck.
Yeah.
Like you can't fit a tank into the back of a dump truck. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It would be tough to get it in there, but if you did a little work, you could like take a door, take something off, with a cutting torch, and make it open enough that you could drive back into it if you wanted to. You could.
Dang.
I would like that idea if we had a timeline, but we don't. You know, we can't be like stuck doing the A-team preparation work, you know, when they arrive, and it could be like in 5 minutes.
I mean, if any of us are very stealthy, they could, well, have good observation. They could be up on the distillation tower and give us advance warning.
Yeah, I think that.
Or even go further out.
I want Zamuski up here with a pair of binoculars and his rifle because he's a good shot. And
he'll have to get some from the APC then. I'll write that down.
Well, he can have my binoculars. I'll just hand it to him.
Okay, I'll write down the binoculars.
Where do you want Zamuski?
Up here on top.
Okay.
And then we can keep Iona in the in the APC. Now, does someone have to fight? So I assume she would be driving, or Iona would be driving, and someone else would be using the turret to fire. Is that correct?
Yes.
Like you,
yep.
you can't
yeah, you
drive
can't, you
and
can't
fire.
Really do both. Yeah.
All right. So
is that heavy machinery or is that ranged combat?
The gun is ranged combat. Driving is piloting.
Okay. So we might have to discuss between Iona and Chaplin, maybe, who's better at what.
Yeah, you can't kill people, Chaplin.
Yes, I can. I'm a combat android.
Is that right? That's not how I understood this universe, Darren.
Yeah, the combat unit can... Their synthetics can take life, but only under certain conditions. It has to be in defense of another human life. It certainly is not for self-preservation. They are essentially allowed to take life if it saves another life.
Yeah, I feel like realistically she would be like, that, I mean, is he going to freeze up because that's presenting a conflict, you know, if he's on the turret?
Yeah, I would say that Marine commanders rarely assign synthetics to a task that where they're going to, you know, be shooting at people.
Yeah, sure.
You know, it's more the exception that might have to happen than a rule.
I will point out that Chaplin offered it for role.
Yes, yes, and I think that might surprise the captain to hear him say that. You haven't worked with tons of synthetics, but you've worked with a few, and you have never once heard a synthetic offer to take a combat role.
She just kind of stares at him when he says that, smoking her cigarette and just like thinking. I think that's the first time a synth ever offered to kill someone.
To be clear, I offered to defend my squad.
Yeah, well, there's...
If you'd like my advanced piloting skill instead, I can use those two.
I think maybe that might be best. You and I own inside the APC, the turret. I mean, him on the turret. And, Jamuski up on this tower. Let's see, how easy is it to roll up this door?
It hasn't been rolled up in a long time.
Okay.
So it's going to take some effort, but... You can get it up if you really want to. it's like being a 54-year-old guy.
I was picturing how much time in combat is that gonna be around to lift it, or
it depends because you haven't tried to do it.
Yeah, well, she's gonna try. I mean, she's gonna.
Yeah, it takes some effort, but you know, you could imagine a strong person getting it up pretty quick. Like, you know, one combat round, but it is not a smooth roll.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, she'll.
And it's loud, and it is loud and screechy.
She's hoping she gets like a warning from Zemuski or something that somebody's coming, and then they start.
Oh, I'm just saying, you know, just as you're practicing, seeing what it takes to get this open, mm-hmm. what it's like. It's as you're forcing it up, it is loud, and there's a lot of metal rubbing sounds.
So this is a door, and this is a door. She's gonna tell Mason to get on this distillery, I mean the distillation tower.
Okay.
Just in case they come in from the other direction.
Mm-hmm.
And she and Hammer will position themselves in here. by the door and wait to hear from the lookouts.
Okay.
Mechanically speaking, was Mason able to recover from the injury?
Yep.
No problem. Mm-hmm. Okay.
No problem.
And then the camaraderie thing, that is a special skill that you have to be able to use?
It is. Everybody is going to automatically restore one stress. But the captain has split you people up with assignments, so it's really only if Hammer or Silva have it that they can affect one another, and if Dante or Iona have it that they can affect the other person, right? So who has that banter talent?
That's Iona.
Okay. So Iona and Dante can both, and I'm going to bring them back because you are going to come back with the... they can both recover two of their stress. Everybody else only recovers one.
Yeah, Dante's not going to stay in the tank either because that's kind of useless. There's only one turret.
So they do drive the APC back. They come and you want it positioned in here.
Yeah. I'll put Dante here against the wall. Cut out some of the cold wind and still have some line of sight here and here, and hopefully if she's not presenting too much of a profile, she's not the most visible.
Okay. So Iona is the driver.
And no, Chaplin's the driver.
Oh, Chaplin's driving and Iona is shooting.
Yes, okay. Because that I just can't see the captain putting him in charge of shooting.
Iona's a little bit of that somebody else is driving his APC, but it's fine.
Or his APC? But I reckon since Chaplin and Iona are fairly tight, you know.
Yeah, we're buddies.
Exactly.
There had to be someone.
Chaplin explained, you know, now that we're together in this thing, we can give the squad good support. If we see any more monsters, you can vaporize them with the plasma guns or the Gatling.
Okay. All right, so you guys sit and wait. You've got two lookouts on the towers looking around.
I'd say we try at least a little to camouflage the APC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense. Pile a few, you know, old corrugated steel metal, up against
exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And what about the prisoners? You've got three of them.
They're just gagged, and one of them's probably dead.
Yeah. Yep. this guy here, I am gonna. He's gonna bleed out quietly. Like, you're not even sure when he died. He just dies quietly at some point.
I'm not sure Silva even really realized the extent of his injuries.
Probably not.
Hammer did.
I know.
So time starts to pass. I mean, half an hour goes by. And then another half an hour goes by. It's been about an hour, and your comms comes to life, it's the major.
Okay.
And he says, Captain Silva.
Yes, Major.
Says I'd like a situation report. I haven't heard from you in a couple hours. What's the situation?
We are situated at the location where handoff from the Marines to the UPP was to take place. We arrived ahead of them, secured the location. We have a UPP captive alive, and one informant from the insurgency. We do know the location of the insurgent's headquarters now. We are currently... Yes, it is in the northwest parts of the oil field. It's a building that used to be transpo hub. There's a stone wall around it. Probably 20 men at the most. They are being led by a former Marine by the name of Botus. Don't recognize it, but sounds like an asshole.
He nods. He says, "Well, if you know where the headquarters are, what are you doing sitting there?"
Because the Marines are supposed to be coming here. There's no telling if they are there or on the way here. Here we have the element of surprise and fewer combatants to take into consideration there. They have the defensive position and many more men.
He says, "Well, it's your call, Captain. The time's running out. Don't wait there too much longer."
"I won't. I've got a ticker on it. We won't be here more than a few hours at the most."
"I don't know if you got a few hours, Captain. Things are heating up. We're picking up a lot of UPP chatter."
"So, how much time you reckon we have?"
"It's hard to say, but we're talking hours, not days."
"Right, right. I was contacted on a secure line by, I'm turning to my notes real quick, hold on."
"Ms. Eckford?"
"Yes, by some scientist named Eckford, Weyland-Yutani."
"Mallory Eckford contacted you directly?"
"On a secure line, yes. Said that there was, some of their critters are loose. We did run into one of them. I don't know exactly what it was. Some
critters
cooked up in the lab. Yeah, it's I don't know how to describe it. I didn't get a good look, but larger than man size, quick and vicious. Attacked one of my men, killed one of the locals. For some reason, she thought it was imperative to contact me regarding this, but she offered to help but would not offer up her location or the nature of that aid."
"Well, do not involve this woman in your operation, Captain."
"I did not intend to, Major Hatfield. Them Weyland folks are unpredictable at best."
"This is a purely military operation. She has no involvement in this. It's not her concern."
"I understand. We may want to in the future look into how she was able to gain access to this secure channel."
"Yes, sometime in the future we'll have to do that. Right now we've got bigger fish to fry."
"Indeed we do, sir."
"All right, Captain Silva, you carry on and you let me know if anything happens. And like I said, don't you wait there too long. Time is running out."
"I roger that, Major."
"Yes, over now."
She turns off her comm. She'll get on the comms with everybody else and tell them that she's heard from Hatfield and that they're going to wait here. She's going to give it another 30 minutes, maybe 45, and then they're going to head over to the headquarters because it appears that the timeline has been ramped up.
"Okay. So you wait another half hour, and it is quiet."
"All right. She'll probably give it another 15, and then say, 'Iona, in 15, we ain't seen hide no hair of them.' Pull up the APC to the rear door, and we're gonna start loading in. We'll pick up Jamuski last."
He's gonna try to make a leap from the tower and land. Time it to land right on top there. Geronimo. All right. Like from the other guys. Love that scene.
Aim for the bushes.
Aim for the bushes. Exactly. All right. Okay, yeah, the 15 minutes passes. It's just
all right.
Quiet, and your lookouts are not reporting anything suspicious.
Now she kind of curses under her breath. She hates to give up this relatively secure position, but she gives Iona the signal to come pull the vehicle around here.
Okay. Iona will kick Chaplin out of the driver's seat and we'll bring it over there.
Okay.
Hammer, bring them to make sure they are situated comfortably.
Well, as far as you know, there's three
vehicle.
Of them still. You don't know the guy's dead. He's just been lying there quietly.
Oh, she'll go over. She'll be like kind of nudging him with her boot. All right, time to go. Rise and shine. Yeah.
It was time to go an hour ago. Yeah, he's gone.
Well, she will just kind of shrug, I guess, and say, "Well, I guess we're only bringing two of them."
This guy just looks at you with loathing in his eyes as he's hauled to his feet.
Well, I know some friends who are really going to love talking to you.
Well, he can't say anything, so
nope.
He just looks at you.
She, gestures to Dante and Hammer to kind of yank them up by their zip-tied hands and back and get them on board the
vehicle.
And she'll, call to Mason, on the comms to come on down the ladder and get inside.
Okay, so you all load up.
And she'll tell Zumuski to start climbing down, and they're on their way over.
All right, you drive over, and he meets you down at the base and says, "Always the last one, aren't I?"
"It's the last name of yours. It's a Z. Bet you was always picked last for things in school by them teachers."
He looks at you. And you can tell just by his response, you're probably right. he gives you this momentarily wounded look, and then he just kind of lets out a sigh and goes and takes his seat.
Right.
Okay.
Gonna head down to the oil fields.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
She's gonna try to pull up any specs they have on the area and find where this abandoned transpo hub might have been once upon a time. Like, maybe it's on an older map.
Okay, who wants to make that comtech roll?
Well, I think we know.
I know, I'm just asking for...
Hey, Chaplin, you reckon you can dig up some old records, find this old transpo hub?
I will do my best, Captain. There it is.
Yeah, with one success, it does take him a while to figure it out, but he figures out that it's over here.
All right, so I guess we're headed in that direction.
Okay.
Some GTA type driving.
So Hammer uses the drive over there as an opportunity to brag about, he's like, to the two prisoners, he's like, "You boys see that?
That is UCC Colonial Marine armor right there! Your pussy-ass rounds can't do shit! Those of you could even fucking hit me in the first place, you fucking losers. Amateurs. It's just pacing back and forth between them. You know, he's trying to pump up the rest of the people, you know, in our squad, too, you know, like, get everybody going. Like, yeah, we're badasses, that's right! Every single one, especially you, Dante, assault team! Woo!
this UPP guy is just glaring at you. You don't know what he's thinking, but his eyes say something derisive. Like, you know, you just... You can tell he's looking unimpressed.
Yeah, so I'll give him a little special affection and sit down right next to him, put my arm around him, make sure he gets a good sniff of my pit.
Are they still gagged, these two guys, by the way?
Yes. Well, I guess the gag wouldn't matter so much in here. I'll probably take it off both of these guys in here, since they can't shout and cause trouble.
Guess.
And who knows when someone might decide to say something useful, so...
Yep. Well, he hasn't said anything, but yes, so now you see more of his expression. I mean, it's definitely a dismissive kind of expression. So you sit next to him, put your arm around him, and...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll dig one of the slugs out of the chest armor, like, you know, like... Is this UPP specials? Oh, yeah. It's armor-piercing round, right? This is quality stuff you commie bastards make. And I'll just go ahead and stick it in his mouth, you know, and like... It's better for food than for guns, I think, huh? Need a little fiber in your diet. Swallow that on down.
Are you gonna try to make him swallow it?
Yeah, swallow that hot load, baby. I bet you're used to that over there in the UPP.
Alright. Well, it's a little hard to conceal this because the guy doesn't want to swallow it. So you're kind of, you know, covering his mouth and trying to work him to have to swallow. Captain, you see this? I mean,
she's eventually just like, all right. I can't have him choking to death before the interrogators get hold of him.
I'll let you make a straight up close combat check though to see if you can force him to swallow it.
Actually, if Captain Silva says to leave it,
well,
off,
it's
I'll leave
it's
it
kind
off.
Of before.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you know, it's you could eventually make him do it. Like, there's no way he could hold out forever. But I guess fortunately or unfortunately, the captain intervenes before you've managed to get it down. And when you stop, the guy just spits the bullet on the floor and gives you a grin, a toothy grin.
Yeah. So Hammer leans in. He goes, "Yeah, that's right. I don't want to spoil the interrogator's fun. We gotta leave all those pretty teeth in your mouth for now."
You can see when you mention interrogator, his smile fades a little bit, but he's keeping the grin. He says, he says that I can't wait to see what our interrogators do to you when they catch you, if they take you alive. You look like the kind of coward that would turn tail and run.
Captain Silva, just, she has been pretty calm, like, throughout the whole thing. You can tell she really is probably used to this kind of stuff from Hammer and indulges it even.
Mm-hmm.
But when he starts, you know, talking smack about them, she gets closer, you know, she takes her cigarette out of her mouth. Even though her expression's calm, you know, her eyes are a little narrowed with anger, and she just takes the butt of the cigarette and puts it out on his cheek.
Ooh. You can see it Kurtz, and he kind of powers through it a little bit. Let me see if he can. I am curious. Let me just see here. Yeah, he can't stay quiet. He cries out as you burn into his cheek. His smile is gone, and he starts yelling some curse in sort of that Russian Chinese.
She just says, "What are you crying about? I'm the one who wasted a perfectly good cigarette."
Hammer sparks up the cutting torch and says, "Don't worry, Captain, I got a light if you need one."
He says, you murderers will all pay for this. You are going to be dead.
She just rolls her eyes at him.
Count your hours.
They didn't teach you all how to count over there at the UPP?
He just ignores you.
You're the one who should be counting your hours if you think there's going to be anything left of this place but a little scorch spot here in the view. Honestly, you're one of the lucky ones getting to go sit in a cozy cell with the interrogators rather than just being a greasy, burnt-out smear here on old Ariarchus.
He just shakes his head. And you're getting close.
I think she'll actually start to test during the trip. She's like, you know, them Marines, they were guarding the scientific facility. I ain't stupid. I reckon they got something to sell. It's got something to do with that, right? Maybe some critter DNA, am I right? And she just watches his face for a reaction.
Yeah, he just gets quiet. He just has no comeback for that or comment.
I'll take silence as yes. And she'll just chuckle and say, "Well, looks like them soldiers, they either knew or they chose or they didn't know. They either knew and chose not to tell their prospective buyers, or they didn't know, you know, about their little life expectancy problem." And she just kind of chuckles, like she's just bluffing.
Mm-hmm. But no, he's just getting very very quiet now. He's not looking at you, he's just staring straight ahead.
"Only lives 24 hours, ain't much use to nobody." And she just laughs.
Okay. Well, you're getting very close now.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we are almost at time. So I'm gonna show you the compound as you see it. Just give me a second here, sorry. And because you know, when he looked up those the plans here, I'm gonna give you eyes to see some things. So you can see this is the old compound. I have you guys on there, but you're not there yet. I just have you there for when you do get there. But you can see this is the layout of the compound. There's this sort of triangular shaped high wall around the whole thing. Another lower wall, interior wall, and the main house in here, and then this yard out here.
Are those ships, or are they like?
These are vehicles.
Okay.
Are they the same kind of ATV that we saw at our previous location?
No, they're bigger. Okay. But they are just little transport vehicles. They're not military.
Okay. They're local.
Mm-hmm. So you can think about what you want to do.
I tried diplomacy. This is a pretty well-guarded place.
All right, folks. I'm going to call it here because there's really nothing more we can do in the time we have available.